Now, in the Subscriptions tab, you can go ahead and identify which contacts are going to be subscribed to this notification. So, if you recall, when we first started doing this particular sample notification, the My Note 1 here, I just kind of briefly dragged a subscriber over here or a contact over here, and I did it all real quickly. I didn't go over any of the details. So let's just kind of rehash what we did. We created earlier a new notification called My Note 1. It had a very simple trigger. I then added a second trigger. We discussed briefly the content, and now let's take a look at subscribers. And let's start by just, I'll delete this current subscriber here. Let me show you how we would normally add a subscriber. We add subscribers by either clicking on this and just choosing from one of these groups. As you saw, we have, you know, we have these contacts. The contacts will allow you to go out and do that Active Directory search. So, you know, for example, I think I remembered showing you I had some Active Directory users who began with the name SOLU. Yeah, there we go. These are some of the existing Active Directory clients that have these windows. And so I could use this as a mechanism for adding individuals. I'll go ahead and add Bob Smith. I'll go ahead and add, let me do that again. I'll add one more subscriber here, Solution J Hog. And then in addition, do you remember I mentioned very early on, you could specifically add delivery endpoints that are not associated with a contact. So this would be what you would use, for example, for a web service. Okay. In addition, of course, we can do groups and escalation teams. Go ahead and take a look at those videos if you're not familiar. Those were earlier. Now, that's one of the ways we could have added those subscribers. We could also go out here under this contacts pane here and just go out and search for the search for those contacts. And then once we found them, we would drag, you'd actually drag the delivery point, not the contact name, but to drag the delivery point, or endpoint, which in this case is the email. I'll just drag them over. Drop it right there, and you notice he gets added. Now, you'll notice the very first time you do that, you're going to get some options that come up. And that's something that's available at any point. Now, we've looked at these options briefly when we looked at contacts. So if you're unfamiliar with these options, go take a look at the contacts video. Also, now here's something brand new. If you decide to modify some of these options, like for example, you'd like to choose to notify on close. In other words, if the notification closes, you want to send a notification to everybody. Well, what I can do is choose to copy that to the other subscribers here. I'll go ahead and select the subscribers. I'll go ahead and say OK. And as you can see, not only can you copy them, you can choose which ones you're going to copy. So there we go. We've now copied those for each of the users. So each of these users, as you can see, has his own, you know, his own a mechanism for what content you're going to deliver. Now, one of the things I never like about defaults is you sometimes get way more information than you need. I like look at the subject line here. Oh my goodness, that is 90% of what I can see right now is just the path to the notification, which is great. I mean, I'm sure we need that information, but do we need it, you know, right there? Well, you can change that if you want. If you'd like to just preface this with something like, you know, hey, look at column number one, you know, do that and then have the rest of it. That's fine. You can always choose what you want to include or not. Notification event. And then that will become the subject. So that's what you're going to end up seeing in Outlook. And if you get this to a point where you've forgotten things like the path, you can always go back and restore this to what it was originally. Now, for each and every user, we can set this, or each and every subscriber here, we can set this. And also remember, if we have an escalation team or a group, they would affect that would be one subscriber. So you'd have a way to do this for groups, so you don't have to do it one at a time. And as you can see, each one is individual. So I can decide to include content for the first two, but not for R. Wells. As you can see, these other two get that content, but R. Wells doesn't. So here's where we would set what we actually include in the content. And you know, do we include the trigger input? Do we include the instant RT web parts trend? You know, if I look back here at our original example, we were inspecting this at the content tab. But remember, what we send here, what we decide to send, is not decided here. It's proposed here. I guess you can think of it like that. This is what we propose to send. If you go into subscriptions, this is what we actually are going to send. So keep that in mind as you're working with these two tabs here, the content and the subscriptions, because that content is really just what we're suggesting you can include. And if I want to include all these things, I will go ahead and include them there. Now, there is one exception to the rule, and that is if you're using a notification template and you've got content specified there, that content cannot be excluded. Now, we'll talk more about that in our videos on notification templates.